Welcome back and very good morning, night time. Today, in Change of Voice Part 2, we will go further and we will discuss some of the more tense. In previous lecture, in the change of voice, we discussed present continuous, simple present tense, present continuous, and present perfect tense. These three with detailed explanation and example also. I have mentioned some of the important points, phrase, words like subordinate clause, coordinate clause very deeply, and we have covered these three topics very well. Now we will go further and also we will complete the change of voice. As if possible, we will complete the change of voice in this lecture. Now start. Active rules. First, as usual, subject will come. First of all, look at the title. It's continuous, means there will be ing. There is ing because it's continuous. As usual, some of the points will remain constant. Subject plus object, same. First form of verb, same because of the same in simple present tense. But it may be in perfect tense, it was third form of verb. Whether it is active or passive, the form of verb will be third form. Okay? But here, past continuous tense, because of continuous ing and simple form of verb is first form, object last, subject first, and here it's past because of past, it's here was and were. Okay? If first and second person we will use first, second, as well as third person. I was, you were, and he is, he was. So first and third person was, and in the singular was, in plural were. Okay, in singular was, in plural were. Now let's understand this topic and also arranging all these words in a sentence so we can get words past continuous tense. Subject was ya were as it is a plural, so it is singular and it's past, so there will be was also. ing. Okay, but first form of verb, it's first. What is the first form of verb? It's do is the first form of verb. Do is the first, and done is the third form of verb of doing. Are you getting? Let me explain. If the question is do, this is first. Do. This is the second form, did, and this is for third form, done. We will play our game in first and in third form, not in second. Okay, forget about this. Just play around do and done, first and third. Got it? I subject was past, first form of verb do plus ing, do plus ing and object my homework. This is an active sentence containing all the terms and conditions of all these words. Got it? Now we move to passive sentence. Here, as usual, subject is shifted toward the end part and object is shifted to the first part. Was because of past. Now, in active, it was ing, while in passive, it will be being, means being. In active, it was first form of verb, in passive, there will be third form of verb. Okay? And also, by is added because the activity is done by the subject. The object is done by the subject. Here something is by the subject. Means this by shows the passiveness. So by is mandatory also. Now example. Let's analyze this. First, object, okay, was been. Third form of verb, that is done, I have explained earlier, by subject me. First, in active passive voice, you should know that I is transformed to be, he is transformed to him, that's called pronouns. Okay, we have discussed earlier. Now, I think you understand this example. I have mentioned all the terms, also example. So our past continuous tense is over with active and with passive. One example of active and another example of passive. So very simple. To prepare this change of the voice, you have to learn this content. This is the rules. It's one of the important things to prepare the grammar. Not only change the voice, anything, direct, affirmative, negative, remove, to whatever you are preparing in grammar, you have to learn this rule so you can prepare the sentence by yourself and with that accurately also. Now we'll move to past perfect tense. Here, earlier in the part one of the change the voice, we came across a perfect tense, a simple but present perfect tense. In perfect tense, you have to prepare, it's mandatory that in perfect tense, in active and in passive, the verb is always in third form. Okay? In perfect, in active and in passive, verb is always in third form. Okay, means verb will be like done. It's an example of third form of verb. Got it? Chosen, stolen. Means in perfect, the verb form will be like this only. Third form. It is a mandatory. Now understand this by an example. As a change of voice is very simple to understand, but when it comes to answer or sentence or recognize it and then elaborate the answer. So while putting the answer, you have to remember the points very perfectly. Otherwise, you will get very profound marks. Here as subject he. Remember the he becomes him in passive. It's pronounced. Okay. Had because it is perfect. Had and third form of verb. Because of its perfect, it's had and third form. Had already done his homework. Got it? Object third form of verb. Done. I have given example of this. Just while writing the answer, kept in mind, you should keep in mind all the terms, all these points, blanks plus blanks plus blanks. If you fulfill the blanks plus blanks plus blanks, you will get plus in your marks. Now passive. Here also perfect had passive be perfect third form of object and object subject to our ghar ka sadasya. Got it? In case of perfect, form of verb will be third. In case of past, had been. In case of passive, will be been and object subject to same. Now, example. Here also, been already been third form of verb done by subject. I told you earlier he will become him, she will become her. These are pronouns and you should know. So all the contents we fulfill, we analyze, and we have written the example properly with the help of these rules. Here past perfect tense is over. Future tense active. Here also subject and object. Now there are some changes. First form of verb inactive as usual. Only perfect tense. Perfect tense here there will be chances of change like third form of verb. While is past continuous simple present whatever future there will be only first form of verb inactive. But in case of future we may have something changes that will and shall will be added. All the things are covered. Now passive. Just a second. I think I have not written the example. First of all, let me write the example. Subject. Will first form of verb object. The they will on the match. I think there is changes. They will win the match. They will win the match. First form of verb we covered. Subject we covered. And future tense is will. Also the object is also. So, future tense active is over. Now, we'll go for passive. In comparison of past, in comparison of perfect, continuous and present tense, continuous and simple tense are easy. Just we have to perfect tense only. Thus, you know what in perfect had and had been are also added. Also, third form of the verb. There is a chances of positivity. See, in the perfect tense, there are both in both the sentences, active and passive. Third form of verb is only used. Means you don't have to worry regarding verbs in the perfect tense. Okay. So for perfect, we have benefit in case of verb. While in simple and continuous, present continuous simple tense and future, the verb will be changed from first to third. That is also okay. That I will have to prepare. And one more thing, that in simple present, simple past and future tense, you have to add by or something in passive. And mostly the sentence will be formed in a simple format only. So you have to prepare the rules and the regulation. If one time, if you suppose once I prepared the rules and regulation in your life, you will never get bad marks or low marks in grammar, because the main fundamental of grammar is what rules and regulation. Now we have future tense, object, subject, as usual, we, shall, because of future, third form of verb, because it is in passive, and here be is added. In case of perfect tense, being is added. In case of future tense, be will be added. Got it? Getting? Got. Object, will, be, third form of verb, subject. Here it was they, there it was they in active, and here in passive it becomes in them. The pronouns has been changed, and you have to take care of pronouns also. You can't write they in subject and in the object also. You have to change the pronoun. It is very simple. Here our passive is also over. Future tense is very simple. Now we have perfect. Yes, perfect means we should remember. Yes, in perfect we have third form of verb in active and in passive. Means the verb form will be done, stolen, chosen, and done, whatever. Okay. subject, object, perfect, third form of verb. Subject, object, perfect, third form of verb. Future, shall have, will have. It's future perfect. So because of perfect, we have, we here have. Here we have also perfect third form of verb. Got it? Subject, will have, third form of verb, object. Here the subject will be transformed into, sorry, this they will transform into them in passive. Okay, passive. So object will come first, subject will go last. Because of future perfect, shall have, will have. Also because of perfect, in passive also the form of verb will be remains in third, and in active it was be, and in passive it becomes been. Okay, got it? The object, earlier I said in active the word is they, then in passive it will become them because of pronoun has been changed. Future perfect, shall have, will become, will have. Also addition of been, done because of third form of verb, by is written here, and subject them. Here our change the voice is over. I hope you got very well, because we have discussed literally by giving one example, and at a time single thing I have explained, so that there will be no mashup in your mind. Okay, so in also active I have explained, I have given example, passive explained, then I have given example, same example in active and passive. Each and words I have explained very well. I hope you got it very well. So just prepare it thoroughly. Read and write down. Not most necessary that you should write these rules and regulations. Learn it properly. Don't bug up. Just learn properly in your mind and then practice some examples. You will prepare the chain. You will get chain. Here our lecture is over. Thank you very much.